Hey there, my name is Yevhenis Draconius, and today we're going to do a quick tutorial on how to do blur effects on your EVE Online client streaming. Like, if you want to blur your text area or your system or your local system that you are in, or any area that you want to blur without having to like do window resizing and then just putting a little box and then just make it bigger for the distortion to work. I found out a quick and easy way to do it, and this is my way. This is the way I do it, and I wanted to share it with you because it's fairly easy to do, and you're gonna see in a little bit. So let's just start doing it. First things first, you do an input scene with your game capture. You just leave it like that. Just lock it, and you have your first scene that it's called input. Then you right click that scene and just do a duplicate. Simple duplicate. Then you call this one mask and blur. Right? Because that's what we're going to do. We're going to do some mask and we're going to blur it. So, if you see, they're identical scenes with the same input, and that's it. So, let's just work with the mask and blur one. What we do is, on the mask and blur, we start adding color sources. And you just add one color source. Let's take a color on it. Just take a pink, something that... a color that's dispensable that you can filter out later on, and let's just use this pink because it's a color that's not that commonly used in EVE Online. So we lock the game capture, so we don't want to move that at all, and then just move your color square, whatever you want to put it, right? So what we do is this color square, we're gonna do a lot of duplicates out of it, and you just copy it and you're just gonna duplicate it. 1, 2, 3, 4, let's go all the way to 10. It is important to paste duplicate, not reference, just duplicates. Okay, we have 10. So this is the time where you want to figure out what stuff you want to blur out and what stuff you want to keep with your normal resolution. And the thing is, the squares are going to filter out all the areas that you want to keep without blurring. Like, let's say, oh, this area right here, I want to keep without blurring. And then let's say I just want, like, the name of the system, my route and my text right here. I just want to blur that stuff up. I go to my game. I kind of like find the right balance of the windows that I want to keep on, that I don't want to keep on, whatever. Just take my time, resize everything, and say I'm done. That's it, right? Go to my OBS, and then I just start moving the blocks to all over the area of what I'm, well, you're gonna see it more than words, I guess. Which is worth 1,000 words. Say I just want this one over here and just resize it accordingly. So let's just put it over here, XO. That is perfect. Let's make it a little bit bigger. A lot bigger. This is where you have to spend more time doing this, but at the end is very fairly easy. Let's put this against here, like so. That's the area that I want. This is to the square here on the middle, in between those little spaces there, like so. That is perfect. Let's do like a square over here. That's why I like to do like a lot of squares at the start, so I don't do have to duplicate more squares. Finish. Say there. So I blur that area, and then I just put like a square right against here. If that is done, I just do like a big square to cover everything up. That's it. No? That's going to be my... Those areas that you can see are the ones that are going to be blurred. So what I like to do at the end is I just make a group. And make a scene group with this new version of OBS. And this is called the scene group. Scene group. Let's call it mask. Right. And I just put all my color sources, I just put it inside that group. I'm going to tell you why. Right here. I lock it down so I don't accidentally move anything. And then I just turn it off, on and off. On and off, and try to look for more areas of things that I didn't want to blur or didn't exactly work like that. That's off by a little bit on my client, so let's see if it can work right there. It's just okay. Yeah, I'm going back to my OBS, and that's it. Like, that is done. All my masks are made. So let's do the filters now. Then we go to our scenes on the mask and blur, and we just right click it, and then we add filters. We go to filters, and then we add the first filter that we're going to add is a chroma key filter. We have a chroma key, and then we just look for this color that you choose, like a color type. We use our custom color type. And boom, it takes the pink out and it replaces it with an alpha layer, right? And then what the purpose of this is to add a blur effect. So we add a blur effect on this scene, a global blur effect, and then we just do like a simple, I don't know, box blur or something like that. Simple Gaussian could be simple 5 blur or something like that. Okay, so that scene is finished. So we add our last scene that is going to be our output scene. Output scene that is a combination of the two layers. You just out this one and you select the input layer, and then you select the mask blur layer. What I like about this system, it is that it is fairly easy to turn it on and off. Like, that's my filter, that's not my filter, that's my filter, that's not my filter. And it's fairly easy to turn on and off. Like, whenever you want, you just want to filter in some areas, we just turn it on and off. You have to play a bit with your settings to get it just right, but this is quick and easy. And you have like a blur effect, you can like have like a shortcut on it, and then you, when you're streaming, you just toggle that mask and blur source, and then you can have your blur effects or not. Thank you for your attention on this tutorial. I thank you very much, and I hope it was helpful, and yeah, so see you on the next one.